Hello guys, today in this class I am going to discuss representation of irrational numbers on a number line. So to represent irrational numbers on a number line, I have drawn a line here, you can see, and I have located 0 and 1 on this number line whose length is 1. And you can see again I have drawn a perpendicular line on this number line of length 1. When you meet these two points, when you draw a line between these two points, you can see here that this will be the hypotenuse of this height and base. So how you will calculate the length of this hypotenuse? By using the Pythagoras. As you already know, if two lines are perpendicular to each other, so one will be considered as height and other will be considered as base, and this line will be considered as hypotenuse. So what is the formula to calculate the length of this line? You can see here, 1 whole square plus 1 whole square. When you will solve this out, the value you will be getting will be root 2. So what you will do, now you have to plot this root 2 on this number line. You already know root 2 is an irrational number. So how you will plot this number on a number line? By using a compass. Keep the compass here and open it till the length of root 2. You can see here, open it till the length of root 2, and by keeping the compass fixed here, you'll mark this root 2 point here on this number line. So the same you will do for the root 2. What I have done here, you can see this is 90 degree angle. Again, what I have done, I have drawn a line of length 1 on this number line, on this length root 2. So what this will be again? This will be again a hypotenuse. How to calculate this? Root 2 whole square plus this 1 whole square is equal to root 3. So to plot this root 3 on a number line, what you will do? You will open the compass till the length of root 3, and then you will mark this on this number line. So you see, this is root 3 and this is root 2. Again, what you will do, you will keep on going. You will keep on going to plot all these irrational numbers. I have drawn root 2, root 3, root 4, root 5. And you will draw 4, root 6, root 7, up to so on. You can see here that root 2 is an irrational number. Again, root 3 is also an irrational number, but root 4 is not an irrational number. You must be wondering why I have drawn root 4. Because to calculate root 5, to calculate or to draw root 5, what you need to draw first? You need to draw first root 4. When you will solve this out, what you will be getting? 4 plus 1, which is equal to root 5. That's why I have drawn root 4 on this number line. Because when you will solve for root 4, you know the value for root 4. Root 4 is equal to 2. And 2 is what? 2 is an integer, not an irrational number. So what you will do again? You can see here that I have drawn root 4 by using root 3 as a base and by using 1 as a height. So what you will do again, you will use Pythagoras to calculate the length for this hypotenuse. So root 3 whole square plus 1 whole square is equal to root 4. So with the help of root 4, what you will doing? You will calculate root 5. Root 4, again you have taken perpendicular of length 1. So again you can see this will be the hypotenuse. So how you will calculate the length of this? By using Pythagoras. Root 4 whole square plus 1 is equal to root 5. So now what you will do again? You will open this compass till the length of root 5, and then you will mark this root 5 on this number line. So now you know how to plot all these irrational numbers on a number line. You can do this for root 6 and root 7 and many other irrational numbers. I will be taking more problems in the next video. Thank you.